guys, it's Hopping Hammy. Today's video, I will be showing a room tour since this was requested. Now, this is technically my hamster room, but I shared the space with them. I decided to move in and I do store my clothes and I sleep here because I miss them too much otherwise if I'm in another room. I also want to point out that all of the frozen stuff that you see in here was sent to me by an extremely generous friend. And thank you, friend. I know you're watching this, but I really do appreciate it. And actually, a lot of the stuff that's in my room was sent to me by friends. So I will be showing a detailed tour. I had asked on Facebook and asked if people wanted to see a lot of details, and everybody said yes. So there will be a lot of details in this. But anyway, I guess we will go ahead and get started with the room tour. So this is just a wide overview of what the room looks like when you open up the door, and yes, there are a lot of colors going on. I'm a kid at heart, so what can I say? As soon as you walk in on the left, I have this flower pot with this flower family, and they're all smiling. They make me so happy when I see them with all their different colors, and they're just so cute. I think I found most of those at Target. And then this is my Roborovsky Dwarf Hamster Ginger Snaps 55-gallon aquarium. I have it connected to another aquarium in my room as well. He has a natural theme he really likes. Now, if you want to see this like really in detail, I will link a video down below so that you can see that. Above this tank, I have these three flowers that are up on the wall. And then on the ceiling, I have these dot stickers, which are pretty awesome. Now, it wasn't awesome to put them up, I will admit that. It took absolutely forever, but they look really great and it was well worth the effort. Now his tank is on this file cabinet that has hamster supplies in the drawers, so I will go ahead and show you what is in each of the drawers. In this top one we have mostly dwarf toys that are all smaller and a lot of plastic colorful stuff, and then I have some ceramic as well. And that's basically just what it looks like. And then in the bottom drawer, this bottom drawer has, it's basically just like a catch-all for random supplies. And I have a dustpan, some extra wheels, and some masks for when I clean the cage, which sometimes I forget to wear them and then I'm sneezing for like the next day and a half. These are extra puzzle playgrounds and tubes and some gloves. So that's pretty much what is in there. I won't slam my finger this time. And then above this unit, I have this digital temperature gauge that shows me what the temperature is in the room. It's very handy, especially when the temperatures fluctuate like in the winter and the spring or whatever. It's a really good idea to have that. You can see it just switched to 70 degrees now. But yeah, it's just very helpful to see that. So Ginger Snap's sleeping in his peanut house right now, but he is so cute. In Ginger Snap's aquarium, you probably noticed this tube that leads out. A lot of people ask me if he scales it and escapes out of the tank. He is not that good of a climber. He can't climb completely vertical. If you are nervous, like I wouldn't suggest doing this for a Syrian, but if you are nervous, you can put a cover on, but he has never tried to escape before. So this just leads out of the tank and it goes behind, and I can't show that very well, but I have a lot of pit stops along the way just so that it's not one completely straight down drop, because I don't want him to fall or get tired or anything like that, but it just looks like that. And then it goes and it comes out. And then it runs all the way down this wardrobe. And you can see I have some stickers on the wall that say tubes. And I will show you where the rest of the tubes lead in just a minute. So over in this corner of my room, I have my IKEA wardrobe, and you can see Sumatra's cage as well. Now above my wardrobe, I have these two bins. The one on the left has different colors of Carefresh bedding, and then the one on the right has some extra hamster tubes. Now at one point I had all of these tubes pretty much out around my room, but I just decided to simplify and to put them in storage for now. It's possible one day in the future that I will set them all up again. So inside of these drawers, or cupboards rather, I have some clothes, surprising, right, in a wardrobe to have clothes, and I have them pretty much arranged by color because I think it looks nicer that way. And then I have some folded shirts down here. And then on the bottom right, I have some PJs. And then on the left, I have a jewelry organizer. I'll just show you in one of the drawers basically what it looks like. I just store my jewelry. It's very handy. So you might have noticed these tubes down here. And the cool thing about these wardrobes is they are literally the perfect height. You can see I can open and close the door and it doesn't get in the way. So that is really handy to have that. And that way I can have my tubes set up around it. And inside of this cupboard, I have this shelf for my hamster food, hamster treats, and just different wooden chews and that sort of thing. Then I also store my extra food dishes that are different colored and different shaped for the various seasons and cage tours that I do. I like to switch them out. If you want to see like the shelf in detail sometime, I will show it, but it's basically just hamster food and all of that stuff. I have these cute stickers over here on the front. And then above that, I have these three plush like throws for my bed. I like to switch these out a lot, and that way I don't get bored. And then below it, I have some socks. Then I have some skirts and some shorts. And then the bottom shelf has some different color jeans and pants. So turning to the right again, this is the view that I get to see when I am sitting on my bed and I'm looking out. It is a wonderful view. I get to see Sumatra's cage. And you can also see Ginger Snap's tubes that go all the way around the outside perimeter. Now they are kept separately and they do not meet because they are different species. So Sumatra lives in this wooden DIY cage, and you can just see this is what it looks like. I do have a detailed tour of this cage as well if you want to see. I will link it down below. And then that cage is connected to these Habitrail ovos. Now I do not suggest using Habitrail ovos unless you connect them to a very large cage because they just aren't that spacious on their own. He is sleeping up here. Well, actually he's not sleeping, he's awake because I'm sort of making some noise in here, but he's just digging around for food. And he's very happy. He also stuffed his tube on the left there, you can see. But yeah, he can get down the other way, so I'm not worried about it. So that's just what his cage looks like. And these colors of the ovo cages are actually what inspired my entire room. I just really like them a lot, so yeah. So turning to the right again, this is another wardrobe that is exactly like the wardrobe I have on the other side. And then above it, I have two more Sterilite bins. One has KT Aspen in it, and then the other one has KT Clean and Cozy Bedding. So inside of these cupboards, this I don't get at all that often, so I just have some dress clothes that I don't really wear all that much. And it's a little bit hard to show holding the camera, but that's basically what it looks like. So inside of this cupboard, there is a surprise. This is my special, I call it my frozen vault. So, ta-da! This is just what this looks like. So starting up on this top shelf, I have some different types of books. Some have stickers, some are like word activity books. And then there are two different colored tiaras. There are also two infinity collector dolls, and then the little tumbler and the magic clip doll that you see on the left. In the middle is this really beautiful tiara, and this is actually pretty heavy. It's surprising how heavy that it is. And then this is an Olaf Helps Me Count book and a magnet play set. It's sort of like paper dolls, except it's with magnet. It's really cool. Down on the second shelf, there are two play sets which have little collectible toys in them, and they are so much fun to play with. Like, I did a little photo shoot with them and everything. Then you can see I have the DVD, obviously, to watch the movie. There are a couple of puzzles. In the middle here, these are some different magnets. And then on the right side, there are some stickers. And that is what is on that shelf. So moving down to this middle shelf, this is probably my favorite shelf. There are two classic dolls. You can see them. I keep them in the boxes when I'm not playing with them. And then in the middle, there is an electronic Olaf. Which I'm going to take out of the room to show you because he sings, and he sings really loud, and I definitely want to show you guys that. You can see I also have two tumbler cups, and then there is a jewelry box in the middle that plays Let It Go, And then this is an electronic magic wand that also plays Let It Go. So I will show you all of the electronic items, and I'll go outside my room so I don't have Sumatra wonder what is going on here. So that shelf is pretty awesome. Moving down to the shelf below, this one is for paper party wear and that sort of thing. I have some plates and napkins, cups. It's just really pretty. I love all the designs on everything. There's also this Elsa puzzle that is in the middle. And then this is a snowflake frame that I found. I forgot I had, I wasn't using it. And I thought it was perfect to put here because it's a snowflake, obviously. The past is in the past. I got that idea online and I made it in Photoshop and printed it out. That is my probably favorite lyrics from the entire movie. It just means a lot to me, so I really like that shelf. And then the bottom shelf has two other dolls. Now these aren't the classic dolls, I'm not sure what they're called. They look a little bit different and they are so pretty as well. And then there are some different dishware sets as you can see, and those are pretty. I love the sparkly mug that's on the right. And then there's a sticker book, and this is just something that I printed out online. And then this is like a magic, you write on it and it like glows neon colors, it's pretty cool. So that is what that looks like. And then if you turn to the right, I have these stickers on the door that say Anna and Elsa. And then I have some snowflakes above them. And then way up here, I put some more stickers that say Sisters Forever, and it just looks like that. So we will continue on with the hamster room tour. So if we turn clockwise to the right yet again, you can see my closet bed, and this is the overview of what it looks like if you are standing in Sumatra's cage looking out. You can also see my little frozen corner over there. So we will start over here. This is Ginger Snap's other 55-gallon aquarium that I told you was connected. You can see the tube that leads out, and then it goes down the side of the file cabinet and around the cupboard, exactly like the other side, so it's symmetrical. So if you would like to see this frozen cage in detail, I'll put this down below as well. There's going to be a lot of links down below. But I do want to show you these real fast. Like, I'll show you one of these. When you push it, it lights up, and it's so awesome. It flashes punchy colors. So you can see this is on a file cabinet as well. So this one, in this side, I keep my Styrian hamster toys, and these are more like the wooden and the natural theme. And it just looks like that. And then in the drawer below, okay, don't slam my finger. this drawer is also sort of another catch-all drawer that has a bunch of just random mix-mash stuff. I have an extra wheel. This is an extra ovo cage that I decided not to display right now just so that my room won't be too cluttered, but I'll use that again in the future. And then just some other extra. Those aren't cookies, by the way, that's a tin can that I use sometimes to transport a hamster in. So yeah, that's what's in that drawer. So if we back up, you can see this corner over here, and I have this Frozen poster. So on the left is this little table with a pink lamp. It's so cozy at night, and I noticed this lamp doesn't seem to bother the hamsters. Like, Ginger Snap comes out, so that's really good. You can see I have Yodel and Strudel's photos on here. I definitely wanted them to be a part of my room because they were a huge part of my life, so I just have their photos there. On the shelf down below, this is a frozen shelf, and in the middle there is a lithograph set that has four photos inside. It's like a folder that you open up. You can see the blue light underneath. That's actually my brother's that he is letting me borrow for a little bit because he doesn't use it that much, but I thought the blue light looked really awesome down here. There's a puzzle in the middle with two little photo frames. And then on the left, this says, "Let the storm rage on. The cold never bothered me anyway." And then the one on the right says, "Keep calm and let it go." Now, these I got the idea from online as well, and I decided to make it in Photoshop, and then I just printed it out and put it in the frame. On the bottom shelf, I just have this spare hamster cage. I don't have it connected to anything. I just grab it if I have to put one of the hamsters in it or something like that, and plus it just looks pretty because it has pink and blue, so I decided just to put it down there and display it. So turning to the right, this is so cute. I love this corner with two Olaf plushes and then two Sven plushes, and I love his little carrot nose. Like, he is my buddy. And this one is so cute too. This one's a little bit smaller. And then these are the two Svens. We have a little baby one, and then we have adult Sven. So yeah. So backing up, on my bed I have this frozen fleece throw, and it is so soft. I love it, and I like all the colors on it too. And then I have this other throw that is on the near the feet that says family forever. And then I have these pillows with two other little plushes. Now these, okay, I have to play these for you, and I hope that the camera picks up the noise because they talk and stuff. So okay, so here's Olaf.
"Hi everyone, I'm Olaf, and I like warm hugs. And who's the funky looking donkey over there?"
So that is, he like says a whole bunch of different things. And then this one over here, he doesn't talk, but he like makes grunting, snorting noises. I hope you can hear that. So those are so cute, and I decided to put them on my bed because they just go perfectly, one on each side. So yeah, like I said earlier, I have these different colored pillows. Back here is a DIY headboard that I made. I basically just got a piece of wood from the hardware store, and I stapled some batting and some material on it. And then I have some photos up here. There's Strudel, Yodel, and then I have one of me holding Yodel. Just a little butterfly wind chime. And then above that is this butterfly. Oops, I just realized I totally forgot to turn my lights on. So you can see I have these paper lantern lights that go all the way around, and they are so pretty. And then above that I have this shelf that has some different like little storage containers. I typically store my tube connectors and that sort of thing up in these. And then I have some dangling tassels. And above that I have these foam letters that say punchy. So I will go ahead and show you. We have these two bookcases that are on each side, and they fit literally like perfectly in here. We couldn't believe how well they fit. So I'll just give you a brief overview of what is on all of these shelves. This top shelf just has a bunch of little odds and ends, like mini notepads. I have some hamster pencils and a LED cupcake that changes colors, and just a whole bunch of cute things that some friends have sent to me. On the shelf below, I have this cream puff drawing. She was one of my past hamsters. And then also a little cream puff felt plush. And then I have a shadow box on the left that has some different hamster erasers on it, and I painted that myself and decorated it. It was a lot of fun. On the shelf below, I have a bead box that is sort of like a tin. I have some candles that are shaped like flowers, and then my IKEA nightlight. And yes, I do use a nightlight. No shame. I love nightlights. On this bottom shelf, we have some different hamster books and other animal books. And then I just have that little wiener dog thing. I think I got that in a Happy Meal, and that is what is on that shelf. So I will walk around the bed now and show you what is on the other side. Starting at the top shelf again, I have some different little hamster collectibles. Pretty much everything on the shelf was sent to me by friends. And those of you who are on my Instagram will recognize this little robo figurine that I had posted a photo of, and these are very cute. And they have all the different species of hamsters. Then I have a reading lamp that is very handy. This is my Hello Kitty shelf. I sort of collect a few Hello Kitty things. I don't go hog wild or anything, but I do like Hello Kitty stuff. And I just have those different things. And then this shelf down here, I have a Hello Kitty calendar. I have two containers of ice cream cone scented bubbles. And then this is a photo of my little dachshund that I had for 12 and a half years. And she was very special to me. She was my best friend. And then I have some little cupcake candles on the right. And then on this shelf, I have a salt rock lamp, just a little owl, ceramic owl. And then I have my alarm clock. And then in this doghouse over here, I keep my two favorite stuffed animals that I pretty much grew up with and I had my whole life. So they sleep in there. So that's just what's on my bookcase shelves. Coming to a close now, I will show you the last little corner of my room. This is behind my door, and I have this corkboard slash grease board. Up here on the top, you can see I have a bunch of different little photos of my past hamsters. Now, I have all of them except for my first two hamsters, which I don't really have photos of. I wasn't in the photos at the time. But you can see all the rest of them, and free cookies to anybody who can guess all of their names in order. You can put your comments down below from left to right, starting at the top, and that would be kind of amusing to see. I also have these little buttons over here. This one says Strudel, and this one says Yodel, and Tori Chocolate Colors 26 sent those to me, and that was really sweet. And then this is a little cute keychain that someone else sent to me, and it looks like Strudel holding a piece of cheese. And down here on this grease board, I just wrote, "It's time to see what I can do to test the limits and break through. No right, no wrong, no rules for me. I'm free." And that's obviously from Frozen, and I like that section of the song as well. And then down here I have some of my tote bags. Now I only put a couple back here, otherwise my door sticks out, but I have a couple more tote bags, but that's just a hamster one. And I got that one from Etsy. I don't know if they sell it anymore. And then this is just a little hamster change purse that says I'm a little short. And then I have another keychain. And then behind my door I have this giant Olaf Frozen poster that says I'm an expert on the snow. I just love seeing that. It's great. Then I have these two Hello Kitty stickers. And I also have this thing that says God loves the real you. So this brings us to the end of my hamster room tour. I hope that you guys had as much fun watching it as I had making this video. Thank you so much for your continued support that you have shown this past year, especially to my channel. I really appreciate it. And I hope you guys have a great day, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!